In The Raven, participants are invited to the wake of Edgar Allan Poe. And when they arrive, they're given a set of AR frames that play audio for them. And they're given a what looks like a lantern, which is presumed to be a light source, but actually contains computing technology in it. And as they walk through the space, they get stories from Edgar Allan Poe, depending on where they walk and what they choose to explore. And so there's no real indication that those things are coming from anything in the space. They're triggered almost by magic. We don't want them to realize that they're carrying around a computer. We want them to think they're carrying around something natural. And that's the power, I think, of the Internet of Things in this context. When you have connected devices and you have the ability to communicate between those devices seamlessly, I, as a user, never have to see the technology do anything. I just carry my lantern and everything happens by magic.
The Raven, 1845. Be that word our sign of parting.
The Raven, in a lot of ways, is a first step towards what this technology will make possible. Pieces where audiences determine their own narratives, pieces where you're a participant in an experience that's narrative and not simply an observer. And at this point, we have no idea what those forms are going to be. We're only just beginning to explore them. But seeing what the potential of the technology is, to be seamless, to be robust, to be reliable, opens up doors to whole new kinds of creative possibilities.